Today, I'm going to explain a film about a scientist who fails in an experiment and ends up turning into an 82-kilogram fly.
Ryan Little.
The movie starts by showing us a science convention in the United States, where we meet the main character of this movie, a scientist named Seth Brondahl. Seth is trying to convince a journalist that he is the scientist who will change history. This journalist is called Veronica Cueif, and at the beginning, she does not believe that Seth is such a brilliant scientist to dedicate a newspaper article to him. But Seth manages to convince her that they have to go to his lab to show her his great discovery. And when they get to the lab, Seth shows her the phone booth, which is like two small rooms programmed by a computer. Veronica is still not surprised, as she thinks that this crap is just two phone booths. Seth then tells her that in order to demonstrate what his machine does, he needs a personal item of hers. Veronica then flirtatiously gives him one of her pantyhose, and when Seth inserts his pantyhose into one phone booth and activates the machine, the pantyhose appears in the other phone booth. Veronica is surprised to see this, because what this scientist had just discovered was nothing less than the teleportation of matter. The conversation continued, and at one point, Seth asked Veronica to please not tell anyone about this. But Veronica left the lab because she was a journalist, and she needed to tell the world what Seth had just discovered. So, when Veronica went to tell her boss about that discovery, her boss didn't believe her, thinking it was all a lie. Seth then sought out Veronica to convince her not to publish anything about his experiment, as it was not yet finished, and for the moment Seth could only teleport inert things and not living things. However, Veronica was still thinking of publishing an article about the discovery, but Seth managed to convince her not to do so. After proposing that in exchange for not publishing anything, he would give her permission to record all the experiments, with which she could then publish a book about the greatest discovery in history. And so, it was that they came to an agreement. Days passed, and Seth tried to teleport a baboon, but he failed in the attempt. Seth didn't know what was going on and didn't understand why he still couldn't make living beings teleport. And since Veronica and Seth were spending so much time together, because they were now a team, they started to become closer and obviously ended up hooking up. Seth continued to conduct experiments and finally managed to find the problem, discovering that it was all the computer's fault since this computer didn't understand how to restructure the meat. So Seth was finally able to program the computer correctly. Meanwhile, Veronica's boss, who was formerly her ex-partner, was outraged that Veronica had started a relationship with Seth, who was a scientist. A few days later, Seth reprogrammed the computer correctly and experimented again with a baboon, and this time he succeeded, as the baboon appeared on the other phone booth. Seth wanted to celebrate his great achievement with Veronica, but she had to leave because she found out that her boss, who was her ex-boyfriend, was going to tell everyone about the teleportation. So she went to see him alone to confront him, but Seth believed that she had gone with her old boyfriend for the night. So Seth, who was jealous, was now a little over the top, and that deadly combination made Seth commit a folly, as he decided to experiment with his own body. And the very slimy one didn't realize that Seth appeared in the other phone booth and was happy because he had succeeded. His experiment now proved to be a success. A few hours later, Veronica returned to the apartment, and Seth told her that he had already experimented with his body and that everything went well. But in the middle of the night, Seth wakes up and realizes that he has become much stronger than usual. He also now eats a lot more sugar. For example, he puts about 10 teaspoons of sugar in this cup. And not only that, Seth is like a dog in heat. All the time he wants to do stuff with his partner. And there was also an interesting thing, Seth started to grow very strange hairs, they were thicker than normal. Days passed and Seth's behavior was changing. He had become much more temperamental. He at one point wanted to force Veronica to teleport, so that she could feel how her body became more powerful. And when Veronica refuses to do it, Seth ends his relationship with her, because he does not want to be with a cowardly girl who would not want to try his great invention. Then Seth goes to a bar to meet love again, where he challenges a guy to an arm wrestling and beats him by breaking his hand, and then takes a chick back to his apartment. After doing the deed with this girl, Seth was thinking of forcing her into the phone booth, but just then Veronica arrived and stopped him. She begged Seth to go to a doctor because he had changed too much. He had become very, very temperamental. His face looked like crap, and also his body had a very bad smell. But Seth, who already looked like a different person, did not listen to Veronica and kicked her out. One afternoon, when Seth was looking at his body, he noticed that his nails were starting to fall off and his fingers were leaking a strange liquid. Then Seth went to the computer to check what really happened in his teleportation, and there he realized that the computer had registered two bodies that had teleported, his body and also the body of a fly. One night, Veronica was working on a news story and received a call for help from Seth. Obviously, she went to see him, and when she arrived at the apartment, she was surprised to find that Seth had had the crap beat out of him. Seth explained to Veronica that his body was changing because there was a fly at the time of the experiment. Then the computer took the option of genetically joining these two bodies to be able to perform the teleportation. But even though Seth knew what was going on, he could do nothing to fix it, and now his body structure was changing too much. Parts of his body were falling off, and to eat he had to vomit in his food. Veronica was devastated. This was something totally disgusting. Veronica tried to get help, explaining to her boss what was going on, but her boss only told her not to go near Seth anymore, because this disease could be contagious. The next day, when Veronica went to the apartment again, she saw that Seth could now climb the walls. Seth no longer felt so weak, and no longer felt so bad. Seth believed that what was happening to him was something historic, something worthy of a Nobel Prize. After all, his body was turning into an 82-kilogram fly. He now wanted Veronica to start videotaping his process so that everything would be documented. Veronica's boss saw the videos of Seth demonstrating his body changes and finally understood the gravity of the case. At that moment, Veronica came crying to his apartment and told her boss the terrible news that she was pregnant with Seth's child. Veronica went back to visit Seth, and this time she realized that Seth no longer looked human, as she went intending to inform him that she was pregnant. But when she saw him, she did not dare to tell him. She left the apartment scared. She told her boss that she did not want to have Seth's child because she was afraid, since she did not know what could be inside her womb. When she was in the office ready to lose the baby, Seth appeared, who had followed her and understood what was happening. He abducted her and asked her to please not kill the baby because he was the only thing that could prove that Seth was ever human. But despite Seth's request, Veronica did not want to keep the baby because she was too scared. Veronica's boss went armed to the lab to rescue her. But to his bad luck, Seth attacked him, and not just in a normal way, so used his corrosive enzymes to melt his arm and leg. Veronica told Seth to stop, so Seth stopped and said, Help me be human again. Veronica asked him how he could do that, and Seth explained what the experiment he had planned was. He had three phone booths ready. Seth had to enter one phone booth and Veronica had to enter the other. The experiment consisted of the two of them merging and appearing inside the third phone booth in a single body, so that they, together with the baby, would always be united in a single being. Veronica was completely scared because she didn't want to do it. When Seth was forcibly pulling her into the phone booth, she pushed him and unintentionally tore Seth's face. Seth at that moment was performing his last mutation. He now became the body of a fly. Seth had forced Veronica into a phone booth, and he too had already entered a phone booth. The sequence was ready. There was only a minute to go. But when there were less than 40 seconds left for the experiment to start, the boss appeared, and with the help of his shotgun, he managed to destroy the wires that connected Veronica's phone booth. Seth Fly realized this, so he tried to get out of his phone booth, but he did it too slowly, as the countdown had come to an end. The computer then proceeded to merge his body with the metal door of the phone booth. The chief, who was badly wounded, managed to free Veronica, and at that moment, they saw the result of Seth's fusion. And since it was the union of a living being with a piece of metal, what resulted was a fly with metal parts. Seth couldn't even stand upright. He was a disgusting piece of flesh with no definite shape. Seth grabbed the shotgun that Veronica was carrying, and without saying a word, he implied to his ex-girlfriend that he wanted to die. Veronica didn't want to do it. She didn't want to pull the trigger. But seeing that Seth was suffering, she had no choice but to end the life of her beloved. And that's how this movie called The Fly ends.